Attention, please.
This uploading is only for educational purpose.
No intention to infringe copyrights.
Learning English with Subtitles GPITRAL.
Follow us.
British Sky Broadcasting present a Parallel Films production for MNG Films in association with Kindle Entertainment and RHI Entertainment. Robert Louis Stevenson's Treasure Island. Below fluffy white clouds, a pirate ship flying the Jolly Roger flag sails across a turquoise.
The captain wants to see you on the deck, Silver. You want a hand up?
Nah.
Silver clambers over the treasure-littered floor and locks the barred door behind him. He leads the dark-skinned sailor, who wears a feathered earring, back up onto the deck, where he's greeted by one of the dancing crew. He crosses to the captain and hands him the book. The captain beckons for him to lean closer.
How much?
He whispers in the captain's ear, whose face lights up in a smile.
So we go to the island tomorrow?
Yeah, I do.
Bank the deposit?
I do.
You got it? What?
This is it now, Silver. These days are done.
You're disbanding the crew?
No. I'm going to kill the crew.
He pushes Silver away, and his loyal henchmen raise guns.
There's a jolly boat down in the water. Get the men in there. Take your chances.
Put your muzzles up, Billy Burns.
I said go down, or you will be blown down.
That treasure you're taking, Captain, ain't yours to steal it.
Ben Gunn's getting his words in a twist, but the truth is...
Over.
We've all shared the thieving and the dying.
I am the law on this ship. And I'm sharing with none.
Now, I top things up, Captain. And I know, because it's tattooed on my brain, what each man here is entitled to. Now, let's disband, if that's what's due. But let us all have the lives we've earned, Flint. Let us share in this.
You talk too much, John Silver.
The captain has ignited a cannon sitting by his chair with his smouldering cigar. The cannonball smashes into Silver's right leg. His crewmates drag him to the jolly boat as others dive overboard.
Help you!
I don't know how, Mr. Silver.
Ben Gunn goes to the aid of another wounded man in the boat as Silver ties a tourniquet around his upper leg. Another hands him a short sword. He clamps the sheath between his teeth and chops through his leg with the blade. Eddie Izzard is Long John Silver. Philip Glenister, Captain Smollett. Rupert Penry Jones, Squire Trelawney. Daniel Mays, Dr. Livesey. Elijah Wood, Ben Gunn. Toby Regbo, Jim Hawkins. David Harewood, Bones. Keith Allen, Pew. Rita Kateb, Dujon. Donald Sutherland, Captain Flint. Shirley Henderson, Jim's mother. And Nina Sasania, Silver's wife. Directed by Steve Barron. 3 years later, young Jim Hawkins rushes towards his stark clifftop home, the Admiral Benbow Inn.
My condolences on William's death.
Thank you, Dr. Livesey.
Husband was a good man, a good friend. Jim.
Sir.
I need to step up now for your mother. If there's anything you need or I can do professionally or as your father's friend, then...
Keep in the inn open, sir, so I expect we'll be seeing you.
Then call on me. Yes, Jim?
Dr. Livesey leaves the widow and her son. Jim reaches out and holds his pale, gaunt-faced mother's hand.
On the dead man's chest.
Your fool!
and a bottle of rum. Drink and the devil had done for the day.
A dark, filthy night. A tattered figure pushes a barrow towards the inn and knocks on the door, startling mother and son, who sit by the fire. Jim opens the door.
We're not open today, sir.
Let's have the rum, boy. Let's be having it.
The guy told you you're not open.
Having it now!
The man is Billy Bones, one of Captain Flint's henchmen.
Of course, sir.
This is a handy cove. This place.
Jim hands him a mug of rum, which he knocks straight back.
I want to speak to the man here.
I'm the man here.
You get much company?
Just locals. Bristol traffic stays to the high road.
Then this will be me then.
We don't do rooms.
Yes, we do. We do. If you're paying.
Oh, I'm paying. I'm paying.
He tips coins from a pouch onto the table.
The rum, the bacon and the eggs is all I want.
What do we call you then, sir?
You can call me the captain. That's what you say.
Is this the room, sir?
I need you to do something for me, Jimmy.
What?
I want to know the minute any seafaring man comes down that trap. And one of these will be yours. Each week.
He holds up a coin.
No seafaring man.
And keep the grog coming, boy. Let's keep these horrors away.
A bright sunny day. As Mrs. Hawkins hangs out the washing, Jim shades his eyes and looks over to where their guest stands at the cliff edge, looking out through his spyglass telescope. Later, Jim carries the bottle of rum to his room, where the sailor shouts out and writhes about in a nightmare.
Save with me, my captain.
He awakes, and Jim hands him the rum. As he swigs it back, Jim looks down at the sailor's chest, which has the name Flint studded onto its lid.
Are you Captain Flint? Captain.
Served with Captain Flint, I did. He was my man of honor, Jim. Biggest dog in the sea. He would bite your legs off, Jimmy. He would bite your fingers off to get at your rings. And he was my captain. Flint would line up the officers. He would bind them tight, chain cannonballs to their feet, throw them over the side to see if they floated. But he had honor now. Yes. He was not above a bit of mercy. Send them off on the big, wide, little jolly boats. Letting them take their chances.
It was mercy, was it?
You want another one, Doctor?
No.
15 men on the dead matches. Yo-ho-ho, and a bottle of the rum. We got the devil and don't hold him.
He's a bit of life, isn't he, Meg?
He drinks us dry. And he's stopped paying.
A cookie's throat was Martin-like!
How are you?
It's a struggle, Doctor, as you know.
His son for what he has.
No.
Meg.
She takes the money Dr. Livesey has put on the bar, as he looks back to the table, where they have been playing cards, but are now singing and dancing.
Drip down all day in those staring eyes. It must not...
A new day. Jim pulls a cutlass from a sheath and points it at a wooden effigy he has made from logs. He spins around to address a leather bucket hanging from the washing line, then turns again to attack the wooden figure with the blade. He knocks its head off. As he turns again, a man with a weather-beaten face catches hold of his wrist and startles him.
That marmite, Billy's. Don't go near the bucket. It's evil.